So kia ora koutou and welcome to this hui, Ngā Pautama Mata Whenua, Practical Māori GIS Mapping Wānanga.
Kia ora everyone, tangi te hira, I also work at Stats with Blaine, and I also pop up to Hokianga, Uru, to Ngā Pauhi and Te Raroa, and thank you all for coming along.
Thanks Tanya. So what we'll be doing today is having a look at how to create a story map, what a story map is, where to find some help and other resources. And I'll be stepping you through some the how to. And then I'm going to get Tania just to give you a short kōrero on something called deprivation index and the census data so that you can access that for this purpose as well. So hopefully you can see, Tania, could you just confirm that you can see the marae?
I can see it.
Here is that document, the kite. So if you go to hider/story maps, you'll be able to access this. There's some links in there that we'll refer to through the session. But I wanted to start with this example story map. So what is a story map? A story map allows you to have images, maps, graphics, video, text, kōrero, and create it in a self-hosted platform. You can have these as private, just to you. You can have them shared to people in an organization, or you can have them public, like this one is. So this one is entirely made up, and hopefully you can access this. If we scroll through, we can see here some kōrero, an embedded video, and as we come down, there's also some interactive maps. So if I come up here a bit and just click on this one, scroll story map automatically, you'll be able to see, hopefully similar to what I can, as it's scrolling by. So all of this I've just built using an ordinary editor, like a Word document, where I've just typed that in, I've added pictures, I've changed the color. And this is for an imaginary marae because I didn't want to use anyone's marae for this session. So I've just, all of this is made up. I was having a look at kumara at some point. I thought, oh, and then I found a place in Chile where they also grow kumara. So I thought, oh, I'll use that as my base. And it looks kind of familiar, but it's very different. So you can see here, I've created a map with some markers, and I've used a zoom and the 3D, and a photo on the left with some kōrero about ko kahurangi pūwhenua te maunga. And I've just gone through some illustrative steps. So none of this is based on any truthful kōrero. It's just made up for purpose of demonstration. But you can see it looks very familiar to Aotearoa. I've kind of made up the story of it out to. So you can see as this plays through, it's going through 3D views, and this is also interactive. So you can actually just pause it and move the map around and have a look and zoom in, zoom out. Just press play again. And there's a wee video embedded just here. I'll just see if I can hurry this one along. And also a video embedded just here. Now, if some of you may have noticed, just back up here a bit, it didn't get picked up in the automation. It goes just scrolling back up. In this case, there's a soundtrack. Let me see, I thought I had updated this. You can press play on that soundtrack and it'll play for the duration of the story map. It looks like it's not working for some reason. I have to just republish. Let's come back down again to where we were. So you can embed video, you can embed a video file, or you can use YouTube or any other hosting place where you might want to store your video. add some kōrero. And so what I've done here is I've used a basic structure from a funding application. And it doesn't matter what format or what purpose you're using the story maps for, but in this case, I've kind of used that as a framework to help build the story. This one here is just a standard static image map. It's still, if I pause that there and just come back a bit, you can see it's still interactive, so you can actually still go in there and move around. And this is also the design is responsive. So that means when you look at it on a phone or a tablet or a computer, it will change itself depending on what the device is optimum for that device. So you can see we've got headings, I've added in some imagery. And in this case, what we're doing is a place-to-place tour from just two points, one and two. And I've added a photo of Te Kūmera, Kāinga or Te Kūmera. This was my kind of imaginary story. And as we come down to the next one, I kind of add this voyaging theme because this is far to the east. And also these, so we don't need to have data for this 3D to run. We can just put it on as points, and I'll show you how to do this shortly. Just scroll on a bit more. And then we can add headings. And this is another feature of story maps that allows you to have photos as a gallery, like this. Oh, that's just a little photo. And we're going to have a look at as well of how we can better use census deprivation and other information to share where whānau live, things like population density and how that this what this map is showing us as well. And I'll hand over to Tania in about 20 minutes or so for her to just have a kōrero about the deprivation and the census data and how you can access that. So this also is just a simple basic map, and I've added a pin and I've added a little icon and with a little pop-up like this. So all of this you can do yourself. There's no coding involved. It's just building in the same way that you might use Lego, drag and drop and add things. And then credits, and always better to use credits as you go. So what I'm gonna do just now is very quickly just show you how this story map is constructed, because there's many different ways I could show you this. I think this is probably the simplest way. Can you hear me okay, Tania? Going okay? Kia ora. So now I'm in editing mode. I'm just going to go full screen. What I can do is there's a couple of things that I can't change. So every story map must have a heading and doesn't have to have a subheading, but does have to have this first part of the story map. And I can change it to a few different options, but every story map must have a heading. Coming down a bit here, we've got some navigation links. So these drop down to other headings further down in the kōrero. I've got a hyperlink here, which I'll come back to, but this is an image, and you can see I can change where that image goes. So if I just press that and go publish, republish. So hopefully if you want to just refresh the view on your end, if you're looking at the story map yourself, in about 3 seconds, 5 seconds, you'll see that image is on the other side. So it's updated live once you press publish. I'll just go back into edit. Coming down a bit, I've embedded, I thought I had removed this. I'm just gonna remove this one because it's just not working. And I don't know why there was some kind of issue that's happened just there, probably because I was doing it on two computers. Here, this is the real meat and potatoes. I think this is the the real winner when it comes to sharing a story with Māori. 3D is just a no-brainer for, but honestly, it doesn't matter what topic, whether it's for funding application or to support kōrero, 3D is just the business. So you can see here, as I'm scrolling down, it's going from 1, 2, 3, 4 slides. So if I click on this, this is in the editor view. You can see that these are just slides, just like you might in a PowerPoint or something like that. And I'm just going to show you how I created them. So what I've done is gone to, I've added the picture, added the text, and then I've gone add the location. So if I edit the location in this case, or edit the view, I can click on that number and I can move it, which the number doesn't really do much. It's just a placeholder. In this case, I'm starting with the Maunga. And if I go and just leave it there, I've changed it. So what I've done to navigate is using the left and right click. So left click on the mouse, right click on the mouse to spin it and go done. Now, if I go publish again, which I could, you'll see that it's updated the view from that more vertical view to a kind of slightly more oblique view. And so you can set that view however you want. What I've also done is I've done a cluster of 3 or 4 places, so they're quite close together. So when you go from one to the other, to avoid your audience from becoming dizzy or losing the view, losing orientation, is you kind of have to relate those views in some kind of series so that when you go from one to the other, you can kind of see the previous part from where you just were, so they can get the feeling of where they're moving to. Or so sometimes you may have to adjust your story and your views just to make sure that you don't lose the flow of your kōrero that you're sharing. So I'll show you how to create these. This is a video. This was a video I took on my cell phone. And so I uploaded the video. I put it in there and it's a slow motion video. It just looked cool. And we had this theme of the volcano and the fire, the home fires. I thought that looked quite neat. And then this picture here is just an embedded view. Can be a 2D map, can be a 3D map, and you can adjust and change this view however you like as well. This one here is a picture, so we can change how that picture is, where it's situated in the story. And I'll just show you as well, just while we're here, how we can drag and drop. So see this handle on the side? We can change where that picture sits. And we can move it left, we can move it right. Or we can change it as well if we want to. It's our story, so maybe if we're doing a pepeha or a motete or something like this. So you can have a slide for each location you want to go to. So if I was to add a new slide here, I just wanted to show you how easy it is to create these. So no coding, just all point and click, and I'm going to show you the detailed instructions on how to do this as well. What I've done is I've just pressed the plus. I add an image, so I'm just going to go to my hard drive, find the image. Okay, here's one, just use the Maunga again. Add. So all I've done is I've added this slide, number 3, I've added the picture, and now I'm going to go here to Maunga, and I could put a description there if I wanted. And now the last part is to add the location, and this is the important part. I'll just zoom out a little. Add location. So now I'm setting how I want the map to view. So if we zoom out a little, and I use the right click on my mouse, and I'm using left click to pan around to move it. I'll show you how to do this. And I just want a view of the Maunga here. So then I'm happy with that view. I go add. And now it's part of the story. So if we go back in there and I just edit it again and change that from there. I thought I had that here. Not sure why it's changed it. I go done. Okay, it's not behaving as I want it to, but catch it by. Close enough. You get the idea. So that, can you see how this is within one section? All of those three slides, 1, 2, 3, it starts about there where that line is, and this section is like a container, and within that container is some slides, 1, 2, 3, 4, or 3 in this case, going from place to place, and the placing of them. So if I want to move this one, Te Kāinga o Te Kumara, if I want to move that one from that location, I'm editing the Kumara location, not the number 2. Let's say I picked the wrong area and I wanted to go and put it representing in this area. Then I press done. And so now that's updated. And if I press publish after this, it'll be reflected in your site as well. So coming down here, this is a map that I've embedded, and we may need to send some notes on exactly how to do this after this hui. But we can add in maps of other things as well. And this is a live real map. So this is real data coming from StatsNZ through Eagle Technology, hosting it as a map service, but don't worry about that part. We'll show you how to add this as a map into your story as well. But we may need to do that after. But I'll get Tania to step us through what some of those census variables are and how that deprivation information is made available. And in our past couple of wānanga, previous month and month before, we go into some step-by-step instructions of how to create a map like this one. And you can do this with the free ArcGIS account as well. And we'll have a look at how to create this map. Okay, so I'm just going to press publish. Publish there. And for those of you looking at home at your own story, if you press the little swirly button up the top right of your browser, this one just up here, hopefully you'll now see what I've just published. And you can see that's on the other side, and just like this one. So that's what we're aiming for. And so now what I'm going to do is show you some links, because this is just an hour session, but really we need much, much longer to go into detail on all of these. Kia ora, Lara. Thanks for your comment. Ka pai. What I want to mention is this, what is this, where is this stored? So all of you will know Microsoft Office or Office 365 online. So this is an equivalent in a mapping sense where the company is called Esri and they have a suite of tools called ArcGIS. One of the cool things they do is they make story maps and a very basic plan, similar to Microsoft. They make it available for free with some constraints, some limitations. You get what you pay for. But you can also pay a small amount, which is like $100 a year, which is what I pay to be able to do this. But if you have an organization trust, you can ask them to support you, to support this mahi. You can get a trial account, and each year, I think Esri does give a giveaway as well. So in about November, they have what's called a GIS day, and they provide sponsored accounts. So if you like me and every dollar counts, then keep an eye out for something called GIS day in November, where they do actually have, and last year a lot of us got the free accounts, $100 worth for nothing. So keep an eye out for that. But in the meantime, you can do this for free. But if you have a trust and you can access a little two-tier, then it's definitely worth doing. What I'm going to do just now is just bring this other page back up, this one, Kete for Story Maps. So we've just had a look at that, and I've sort of shown you a little bit behind the curtain, but now I'm going to show you how to actually go and get the curtains for yourself. So the first one is create a new ArcGIS Online account. So for those of you who don't already have one, you can go here and you can create one for free. And this is called a public account, as in a member of the public, not public as in everything's out there in public. What I do is I use my Google account to, so I don't have to have another login, sign in with my Google. So what this is a personal account for non-commercial use. If you have a hapu, a trust, post-settlement organization, then you can get non-profit pricing, which is quite cheap, similar to the personal account. But if you want to use it for commercial purposes, like forestry, farming, things like that, then same with Microsoft, you have to pay a little bit more, and it's maybe $300 or $400 per user each year. You only need one to be able to create, and you can share it in public or just keep it private, in the same that I've just shared with you, this story map. So you create your account there. Once you've created your account, then you go to storymaps.arcgis.com, and you can see here some other stories that I've made. And in this case, the idea for this session was to, okay, how about we use story maps for the purpose of a fund to support a funding application? So rather than just sending a Word document, we can send that Word document, but we can also send a link to a story map to help support our case, to help whoever that funding decision-making board, and this could be a trust, could be the iwi, could be the raunanga, could be an agency, could be the council, doesn't matter, because you can use it for any of those. In this case, with the Oranga Marae, they have somewhere just here, I think. Yeah, there was a PDF that I based. I put that in. Whoops, I might not have put that link in there. There's a PDF. Where did the PDF go? Okay, somewhere on this page, there's a PDF. And on that PDF, it has a range of headings. And a lot of those headings are what have manifested in the Marae Development Plan. There were, for example, introducing the Marae, the location, your vision, what your aspirations are, who you are. Some of these, you can see some of these questions here are straight from that funding application. Aroha mai. I've got to find that maybe just while Tanya's telling us about the census data. So how do we create one of these story maps? First one is you sign up for an ArcGIS Online free account. Second one is you go to storymaps.arcgis.com. And then we just create a new story. So if we go new story, start from scratch. Ah, kia ora, Delwyn. Delwyn's just put the PDF that I was after on the chat. So this is this PDF. Hopefully you can see it there. Can you see the PDF that I'm just showing, Tanya? So this is what I sort of loosely based my story map on, some of these headings and answering some of these pātai. So you'll be able to see right there, it's literally represented in that story map that you can see. So how do we create one? We go new, and you can see now we're in the editing part. In here, we put here, if I just be cheeky and copy from here to save me a little bit of typing. Oh, here we go, our Marae development plan. I'll take some of that text, paste that there. And just like this. So something else just to keep in mind is that story maps is a great way to present, but it's not an easy way to edit. It's not a great tool for word processing. So if you can, write your content in a Word document. Now I do have this content already just sitting ready for us. Let me just go and grab it. Where did I put it? I put it in hide/potama, which is our main folder, resource folder. Standby, please call it. I'll just go and grab this again. Here we go. And I'll just share this link. Anyone want the link? Copy link. Done. So I'm just going to put in the link, just for those of you who, I wouldn't recommend using this, but it's just to show you content of the story map. And this is one of the great things about using Google Docs, is I can do this real time, apply, and you can access this as well. Just put this on the chat, just so you can see where I've got that content from. I sort of collected it. Number of pictures, and I just put that into a folder so you can have a bit of a tutu if you're looking for some content as well. But I'm sure you've got your own. So let's go here, and I'm going to go and tell the story. So I'm just going to copy it from here. So I'm going to copy this text, just call it all. So better if that's in a Word document, and I'm just going to paste it right there. So let's have a look. How do we build stuff? So this is kind of like the kite of standing at the kitchen cupboard, going to open the cupboard now, and here's what's in the cupboard. All of these are the tools that we can use, all the parts, kind of like little different pieces of Lego. Some's bag of flour, potato, this one's kumara, this one's bag of peas, and there's the freezer down there as well. So there are different parts that we can add to it. So you can see it's pretty easy to comprehend what these are once you looked at it for 5 years and several times a week, like some of us have, but I know some of you will be seeing this for the first time. So you can add a block of text, you can add a button to click. I don't use that one very often, to be honest. Separator to draw a line between two sections. Code, that's just for the geeks. So that's actually putting some code. If you wanted to use a story map for telling, for sharing some information about some project or where to get some actual software code, but ignore that one. Map, that's an important one. Image, that's where you add a photo. Image gallery, where you can add multiple photos. Add a video, so you can add a file. So if you've got a video of, say, Komatua, sharing some kōrero, and you've captured it on your phone, then you can upload that to here and it gets stored there. And also in terms of ownership, it's anything you do in this system is yours. No one else claims any ownership. You can remove it, you can delete it. It's held securely. It's as secure as Microsoft Office's, as Google Drive's, as OneDrive, and any other thing. It really comes down to what settings you put on it. You can add an audio file so you can have more tutu, and you can have that start playing and it'll play all the way through. You can embed something from somewhere else. So if there was a report on, say, an iwi site or Hapu's website, and you wanted to embed a link or embed a view of that, you can put it there. Swipe. So in our previous two sessions, which I've done the editing of the video and they'll be available for looking at shortly, you can swipe between left and right, between two images, like a before and an after image. Timeline, I haven't used much, but if, particularly if you're doing a kōrero about treaty settlement, for example, you could use timeline to show activities or events. Slideshow, this is where you have a full screen picture. I haven't used one of those in that story map, but what I did use is the map tour. So what I'm going to do is add the text that I have on that clipboard, and then I'm going to add the map to it just to show you how to create that place to place to place. A couple of pata in there. So you don't have to add, you don't have to pay to be able to do what we're doing just here. You can create using the free account. But if you did want to perhaps purchase the full Monty for Marae, they start from about 300 for nonprofits, about 400, something like that for multiple users. But Roland Pormana, who many of you will be familiar with from our previous hui, we'll have him along one of these sessions as well to explain that. But you don't need to invest any pūtea at all to be able to do what we're doing today. We go next. And in this case, I'm going to use map focused. And other question there about ChatGPT. Yes, it's safe from ChatGPT. They can't scrape it unless you make it public. So for example, Marae Development Plan, I've made public. So it's in the same as any other web page that's out there. Google will search it, they'll index it. So at some point in the future, say if I leave this here for a couple of weeks, and you do a Google search for Marae Development Plan, this will come up in the search results eventually. Where were we? Back here. Okay, so if we want to build this place-to-place-to-place tour, then what I'm going to do here is we're just going to do this really quickly, because the best way to learn this is by tutu, and I'm going to share with you shortly the help information of how to do this. So let's say if we have this maunga, and this maunga is down here, over in this place. The maunga. Come and we go add location. And I'm just scrolling in with my mouse. And because I'm familiar with our maunga, I know that it's about there. And I'm going to go add location. And I'm just going to go and change some settings here. So I'm just going to go in the settings cog. And maybe not that setting, my other setting, edit. And what I'm going to do is change this to 3D. And also, I'm going to change the map from a simple base map to an aerial image map. And then go done. And I'm going to edit location again. And oh, it's just about there, just missed. So now what I'm going to make sure that I do is click that one, move it. Now I'm going to click right click and it's going to tilt like this. And go use the current zoom level and go done. So I'm just showing you here how you can build your own very, very quickly. If we add another, browse your files. I'm just going to see if I can find a file here. Kumara. And so in this case, I want to sort of show that we're growing the kumara on the steps of the maunga. Add location. And click here, using left click to move it, right click to tilt it, and the scroll of the mouse to zoom in. Maybe not that far. And maybe just a view like this. So my previous view is of the manga. The next one, I kind of want to relate to the previous view of the manga so that I don't have to sort of disorientate my viewing audience. So now when I click on this one, I come there, I come here, and I scroll down, and I can continue adding to my story. Let's say I want to add some more kōrero. So this is how I've added this kōrero. Let's grab some text here. Add some kōrero there. And now I want to just do a very simple map. Not 3D, but just a map, just a simple map to show. I'm going to go new express map. I know this is a lot to take in, but remember it's recording, and I'm probably going to redo this recording once I'm not so clogged up. And we want to show, want to have an aerial image for our base map. So I'm going to come over here and go aerial image over here, this one. Remember these buttons just here. So there's a lot of clicking, but there's no coding. So anyone can do this with enough tutu. A couple of patai on the chat there. Yes, you can unpublish. You can publish and you can unpublish. You can also keep it private. You can also, if you have an organizational account, like a non-for-profit account with your hapu, your trust, then you can have it just private to that hapu. Let's say we want an overview map, we want an image there, we want a legend, we can turn all the widgets on. Actually, I'm going to turn that one off. And go place. So if we just want a simple map and we have this neat inset overview map here, or if we go back in there and edit, we can add a pin, we can add a diagram area. In this case, I'm just going to put a pin and change the color. Kia ora those two wharetoa. We're just buying a whenua for a minute. We can change how we want this map to appear. So if we just want to say this is the location with nothing much else, then that map is done. So if I press publish, you can see here that it's private just to me. So you can't see this one apart from when I share my screen. I can change how I want this text to appear. I can change the picture. I can share it to a group if I have some groups that I want to share it to that are set up in the ArcGIS system. Or I can set this to public. So if I put this to public and then press publish, you will now be able to access this if I share you the link. I'll put this on the chat. There we go. So it's a pretty rough map, but you can now access the story map. So that's just the very quick how-to. So in the Pānui, I put minimal instructions, but maximum tutu. Now here comes the tutu part. Back to our kite for story maps. Here is the full tutorial. So if we click on this one, you'll get a full tutorial on how to create and use all of those components of story maps. It takes you through step by step, by step, by step, by step, by step, by step, building, using those tools, creating and adding pictures. In the link just above it as well, there's a gallery. So there is a number of stories that have been created by others and shared in public. And so you can use these as inspiration to for ideas and thoughts of how you want to share and create your own story map. Let's see, there used to be one. Used to be some, be able to filter by type. Category. Oh, yeah. So you can go in here and have a to-do as well. Okay, so one thing that we haven't come to is using and accessing the census data. So how you can, to support any funding, you probably want to refer to the area where whānau live, where how many, any kinds of aspects of information about the whenua, about the hapu, those whānau that live there. So I'm going to hand over to Tania just to explain a little bit about, just for those of you new to our sessions. But Tania, remember we've done previous couple of sessions where we've talked about how to create these maps. So maybe just get you to tell us about the deprivation and the census data and just where that's stored and how it's where we access it. And then just whānau, if you refer to our earlier tweet, that will show you how to create those maps. So I'm just going to stop sharing my screen and just attend to some of those pātai on the chat. And over to you, Tania.
Oh, thank you, Dwayne. Okay, so I'll just quickly share my screen. All right, so hopefully everyone can see this.
Okay.
All right. Awesome. Thank you. All right, so first I will quickly talk about the New Zealand Deprivation Index. So the NZ Dep Index is a area-based measure of socioeconomic deprivation in Aotearoa. It measures the level of deprivation for people in a small area. And these areas, they used to be defined by mesh block, but since we've developed statistical area ones and statistical area twos, they're since 2018, they're kind of coming out as based on that statistical area one area. And it's University of Otago that creates this index that's based on a whole bunch of census variables. So specifically, it's based on 9 census variables. And they can change from census to census. So there is some information on it on the this website here, which I'll add these links into the chat. But in particular, the 9 that they've used for the 2018 deprivation index is people with no access to the internet at home, people aged 18 to 64 receiving a means tested benefit, people living in equivalized households with income below an income threshold, and people aged 18 to 64 who are unemployed, people aged 18 to 64 without any qualifications, people not living in their own home, people under 65 living in a single parent family, people living in an equalised household below a certain bedroom occupancy threshold, and people living in dwellings that are always damp or have mould in them, like larger than 8-4 size. And these, as I said before, variables can change from census to census. And the index itself is represented by displayed as deciles, and this is on an ordinal scale. So I'm just going to go over to where I personally actually like to download this data. So Eagle Tech have kindly have a data set that has both the 2018 census data and the deprivation index attached to that data, covering statistical area one. And so I just mentioned that it's measured in deciles. So you've got decile one, which represents an area for the least deprived scores, and then a decile 10 represents the area with the most deprived scores. So one is the area that with the least deprived scores, and 10 is the area with the most deprived scores. So in this data set here, just click here and show you this pop-up. So as you can see, it's got population density in the statistical area code. And then if you scroll down, it has that score there. So deprivation index 2018 and deprivation score of 9. So yeah, you can download the data set from this website here. And there are couple of download options. Hopefully it appears. Here we go. So can be downloaded, and you've got your CSV, your KML, if you would like to view this data in Google Earth, shapefile if you do have access to the ArcGIS platform, and then your GeoJSON and file geodatabases. And then that is it. And I'll just quickly show you ArcGIS Hub. So if I Google, I search for statistical area one, you can just find it there. And they also have other stats data as well, the boundaries and census data as well. Just click here and it goes to this page here that I just had up on the screen. So yeah, that is pretty much the end of my kōrero on that. So I will pop these links in the chat, and I'll pop in a couple of extra ones that so directs you to some of the data sets we have on Data Finder, StatsNZ.